Hello viewers, in last video we saw the header files, the main functions, the format specifier, and we are going to use those things in today's video. Now we are going to learn basic commands of the basic C language, and we need some compiler to do that, and I'm going to use the Dev C++ compiler. You will find this software, this link to download in my description I've given out there. So let's start. I'm going to open this compiler. So this is the compiler, and I'm going to make a new source file. Here it is. Okay, so in this white page we are going to write our codes. So last time we saw the header files, you know, I've told you the header files. So this is the proper syntax of header files. I told you about this, that this is the dictionary, this is a library where compiler goes and checks the commands. So the compiler will get to know what command you have typed over here. So it is Conio, that console. Console is that black color window where we saw our output. I'll show you that when I will run this. So next we saw the main function. Let's make a main function. You can use anything, void or integer, whatever. This is the syntax. We will write all of the things inside of this main function. So today's first command we are going to use is printf. The basic command, we will always use this. So this semicolon, never forget this semicolon. This semicolon tells the compiler that we are terminating this command after this thing. So these two quotes I've written over there. You, whatever you want to write, you will, you want to print on the console screen, you will write in between this in these two quotes. So suppose I want to write that enter the number. So I want to see this on the black window. So I typed enter the number, so it will exactly type this, print this on the black window. So I think we are done here. Let's see what happens when we will run this. Before running it, we need to save it somewhere. So it is like save as. I'm going to save it in desktop. I'm gonna make a new folder in desktop. I will give the name Oratex. Made a new folder. I'm going into the folder and saving it as test.c. Remember, you have to give this extension, that .c, so it compiler will get to know that this is the C language. File contains the C language. So let's save it. And okay, then execute it, compile and run. Here it is executing, and we saw this black window. In this black window, we can see the enter the number, whatever we written over here between these two quotes, exactly it's printed on this black window. And there are some lines written over there which we don't have to worry about those lines. So these lines will tell you that your program has executed all. If you see these lines, you will get to know that your program is executed totally. So let's close this. And the second basic command of today is scanf. The scanf is something that scans the command given by the user. So this is the proper syntax for the scanf. And sorry, not proper syntax. We need something like this. Now, this is the proper syntax for the scanf. Now, between these quotes, you will write the format specifier, and here you will write the variable. So, now suppose, as I've, if you remember, I've told you that integer, percentage D stands, percentage D is to specify the integer. So, we're gonna enter some integer value over here. That's why we okay. Some integer value over here. That's why we use this percentage D. And after scanning that, specifying that number, we need to save it in somewhere. So that's why we use the variables to save the thing in some memory. So suppose I'm going to use a variable A. I need to define this A, declare this A before I need to execute this scanf line. So before scanf line, I'm writing the integer A. So now I've declared it int A. If you define this, declare this after this scanf line, you will get an error, of course, because it executes line by line. So you have to declare it first and then you have to use it here, otherwise it will show it is an undefined variable. So now you are good to go, but we can see the output. I mean, I will tell you, let's save this and execute it, compile and run. Okay, so it is printing as it is and is enter the integer number. You can write anything over here. So after this, the user will get to know that he has to print enter some number which is the integer. So suppose 5, I'm going to print enter the 5. So you can see those lines are not here, means your program are not totally executed. So if I will enter, then it will be okay. Now the whole program is executed, and now you can see that scanf over here because it has saved the in the integer A at that A variable. That's why we can see over here. So we want to see that value which is stored in the A, so we need to print that A memory location in the console window. How we're gonna do that? Absolutely, we are going to use another printf command. Let's see, printf. So this is the proper syntax, and the number you have entered is percentage D. Now this is going to type, this is going to print exactly on the print screen, but there will be no percentage D on the screen. It will be the value which is stored in the A variable. This is the proper syntax for this printf. Now what it will do, it will go in the A variable. It will take that value and print where the percentage D is. It's specified over here, so it will print here. If it will percentage D is here, then the number will be printed over here. Let's see, save it and then execute it. Now I'm going to enter some number 9. Okay, now enter. See, execution is completed. The number you have entered is 9. So this 9 is here because of this percentage D. If I will put this percentage D between this sentence, then you will get there. Let's see. I'm going to cut. I'm going to paste in here. So you will get integer number over there. Let's save it and execute again. Compile and run. Now I'm going to suppose 8. Exactly printing over there where the percentage D is. Okay, so in this whole program we saw that some new things like variable and integer. So in next video I'm going to explain you about this integer and variable. So till then, keep watching our videos, subscribe and ask anything if you want to ask in comment down below. Thank you.